Hello students, in my previous videos I have already discussed about area vector and the solid angle, and today now I will discuss on electric flux. So what is electric flux? Know about electric flux. Let us consider three figures here. First figure is you have electric field pointing in x direction and a disk is placed in this fashion such that the normal of the disk is going to y direction, and the direction of the normal vector of the surface and the electric field is perpendicular. Now if I ask you a question that how many electric field will cross the surface. Cross the surface means not the tangential upward, not tangential downward, but the electric field line cross the surface like this. So electric field line entered the surface in this direction, and from the other face of the electric of the surface, electric field line will emerge. Now in this case, as the disk is two dimensional, that is its depth is nearly zero, we are only considering the area of the disk, so no electric lines of force will enter one side and exit other side, because the plane of the disk is in the same plane of the electric fields. So electric field line will go tangentially to the surface but cannot intersect the surface. In that case we called that the flux delta phi linked with the surface is zero, because it cannot cross the surface. In the second figure you can see that I have rotated the surface quite perpendicularly 90 degrees. So as the surface is rotated 90 degrees, now electric lines of force can cut the surface, that is it enters the surface in these points and exit from the surface on the other side. So here I can say that electric flux linked with the surface, that is which is proportional to number of lines of force passing through the surface. Now if the electric field have higher intensity, then the number of electric lines of force will be higher, and if the surface area has greater value, then it will also be higher. In that case electric flux is defined as the multiplication of electric field and the total area. So the electric flux is the multiplication of the magnitude of electric field and magnitude of total area here. Now if I rotate the area again, then we can say that electric flux linked with the surface is decreasing. So if the plate in this direction and it start rotating like this, then in the final case electric flux becomes zero, and in the previous case electric flux becomes maximum. So if you take the area in any angle other than 0 degree or 90 degree, then the electric flux will be greater than zero and less than E into delta S. In that case electric flux delta phi is defined as the dot product between electric field vector and the area vector. So in general we can say that the electric flux is the dot product of electric field and area vector, and so it becomes delta phi is equal to electric field E into delta S into cos theta, where theta is the angle between electric field and the area vector. In that case theta equal to pi by 2, that is delta phi 0, And in that case, theta equal to 0 degree, that is delta phi is maximum, that is E into delta S. So we get the electric flux will be maximum if the area vector and the electric field vector is parallel to each other, that is in same direction, and the electric flux linked with a surface will be zero if the angle between electric field and area vector is 90 degree. Okay, now in this figure I have taken an electric field which is parallel lines of force, so uniform electric field, and its magnitude and direction is same throughout the region. And we have few surfaces here. This is surface 4, this is surface 3, this is surface 2, and this is surface 1. The surface 1 has area delta S1, surface 2 delta S2, and so on. Each surface made an angle which are different for the 4 different surfaces. So if I have to calculate the total flux here, so I have to write here total flux phi is equal to sum of individual fluxes, that is sum of delta phi 1, delta phi 2, delta phi 3, and delta phi 4. So I have to take the flux linked with each surface and then take the sum of all of these. Now the in first case I can write that delta phi 1 equal to E dot delta S1. In the second case I can write E dot delta S2. In third case it is E dot delta S3, and in the fourth figure it will be E dot delta S4. So this will give the total flux linked with the surface. And in general, if you have n number of surfaces, then the total flux delta phi will be becomes summation over n equal to 1 to or I equal to 1 to n E dot delta S I. So this will be the total flux linked with the whole surface. Now consider this is the surface as a continuous surface. So if you have a continuous surface, that is this surface, let this is the open mouth of the surface and this is the closed surface. So this is the closed surface. Now apply an electric field here. So I have applied an electric field here, which is uniform electric field. Now to find the flux through the whole surface, first I have to take any small area delta S here. So I have taken a small area delta S here, which is direction of this delta S, and the electric field here in this direction, and the angle between the electric field and the area vector is given as theta. So here delta phi will becomes E dot delta S. Now if you imagine delta S as very small area, then I can write it as d phi is equal to E dot ds. So we can come to the integration, that is differential calculus or integral calculus, from the summation. So phi will becomes Now it will not be summation, it will be integration over the whole surface, integration of E dot ds. So this is the procedure to find the electric flux linked with the surface. And if you have a closed surface, that is a closed surface like a potato, and if you have to find the electric flux linked with the surface, then you have to find the closed surface, that is integration throughout the closed surface, E dot ds. Now this flux phi can be positive or can be negative, because electric flux phi equal to integration of E dot ds, that is E into ds into cos theta. Now if cos theta is greater than 90 degree, then it will have a negative value, and if cos theta is positive, then it will have a positive value. So if you have a surface, let us draw a surface here. So I have draw an arbitrary surface here, and also I draw the electric field. So these are the electric lines of force. I have drawn only few lines of force, but you can imagine many number of electric field in between them, because it is depends on how much you are willing to draw the electric field. Now I will take a surface area here. So if this is the surface area delta S1, this surface has a direction in this way, and the angle is here less than 90 degree. So in that case delta phi, it will have a positive value of delta phi. Now take here another area. Here I have taken another area. Now this is a closed surface and the area are perpendicular outward. So here the area vector will be in this direction. This is delta S2. And the electric field directed along this direction. So you get here theta like this. So this theta is greater than 90 degree. So flux link with this small surface will have a negative value. So this flux is negative. And if you take an area here, so this is the area vector ds3 or delta s3, and the electric field is perpendicular to the area vector. So we can write here delta phi as 0. So when electric field is tangential to any surface, we will write flux linked with the surface is 0. If electric lines of force are emerging out, that is electric field line coming out from the surface, forget about the inside region. Inside electric field have no importance here. So we forget the electric field inside. We can say that electric field lines are entering through these surfaces. So in this side electric lines of force are entering, and from this side electric flux are emerges. When electric lines of force enters a surface, then these fluxes are taken as negative, because in all the cases the normal vector to the surface and the direction of electric field which have an angle between them greater than 90 degree, and when the electric lines of force are emerges from a surface or exist a surface, then the angles are becomes less than 90 degree and the flux will be positive. Right? Now let us take an example. Here we have a spherical surface of radius r and q is the charge placed in the center of the spherical surface. So we know that the electric field due to this point charge on the surface of the sphere is given as electric field E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q over r square into r cap. That is, the electric lines of force are radially outward. So electric lines of force are like these lines here. This is due to a positive charge. Now take any surface. Here we have taken a surface. Now if you take a small surface area on the surface of sphere, then the area vector also will be perpendicular to the surface. That is, the area vector delta S can be written as delta ds into a unit vector in that direction, that is r cap. So delta S and electric field here have same direction. So the flux linked with this small surface will be electric field E dot ds, and we can write electric field as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square into r cap, and it is ds dot r cap. Now r cap dot r cap will becomes 1, so we have get delta phi is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square into ds. So total flux linked with the surface is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square ds integration over whole surface. Now here q and r both are constant, so it comes out 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught r square and closed surface integration of ds. Now closed surface integration, here the surface is spherical surface and ds is a small area, so the total surface integration of ds will be total area of the sphere. That is, this turns out to be 4 pi r square, and 4 pi 4 pi and r square cancel out, so the total flux becomes q by epsilon naught. So if you take a point charge on the center of a sphere, then the total flux through the whole sphere will be q over epsilon naught. It can be shown that to get the flux q by epsilon naught, it is not necessary that the charge should be placed at the point center. It is not necessary. You can place the charge any place, anywhere inside the sphere. You can place the charge here, 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 at any point. In the all cases, the electric flux will be q by epsilon naught. This can be proved, and this will I prove in the next class. So I will take a general surface like an arbitrary surface, and for this arbitrary surface I will take a charge here and I will integrate the whole surface, the E dot ds, and I will get q over epsilon naught. So wait for the next class to get the result. Thank you.